Hi everyone, let's take a look on the Docker commands. So these are the list of Docker commands which we will talk in the details also. Docker run image name is used to start a container from that image. Docker start one or stopped container. Docker start, pass the name of container you wanted to start. So Docker start, stop, restart, you just need to pass the container name. Docker build an image from Dockerfile. So in the previous video we see that I told that we will talk about the Docker build later. So Docker build command is used to create an image from Dockerfile. So Dockerfile is something which we are going to write, and then we will do Docker build and Dockerfile. So it will create an image for us. Docker pull pulls an image or a repository from a registry. Docker push pushes an image to a repository. It's like a GitHub. Docker registry is like a GitHub, where you are pulling the image and you can also push, and you can create a tag and you can just push that image to the Docker hub. Okay, Docker exec to run a command, Docker search, Docker attach, Docker commits, all these actually the commands. So if I talk about Docker search node, so it will give us all the images available with the node. Okay, like Docker exec. So exec minus in the interactive mode, here you can pass the container name which is up and running, and if you wanted to go into the console of that container, this is the command. Okay, Docker start, here you need to pass the container. So you can do a start, you can do a stop, you can do a restart, all these commands are there. Okay, similarly Docker images we have already seen, Docker ps minus a to give all the images, Docker rmi image name to remove a particular image. Okay, Docker build, it require a Docker file. Okay, call it as a Docker file. So it require a Docker file. If you have a Docker file, just pass the name, so it will create an image out of it, and then you just need to do Docker run that image. Okay, so Docker run we have already talked about, like we are passing hello world, so it is actually running the hello world image which is already there. Similarly Docker run in the interactive mode, and open the bash install. So it is running the Ubuntu, it is running the container, it is running the Ubuntu image and creating the Ubuntu container, and I am also entering inside the bash install because I have passed interactive mode. Okay, these are the basic commands, but this is the actual flow of the Docker. So we are writing Docker file, we will do a build on Docker files, we will get the image. Okay, we will do run on that image, we will get the container. Now we can play with the container, we can start, stop, restart that container. Okay, we can also commit that image and we can push that image to the Docker registry. Okay, we can like GitHub, on the Git we create a tag and then we push that tag to the GitHub. Same thing we can do here. Either we pull the Docker image from the Docker registry or we create it from the Docker file. So there are two options. In the Docker file, use the base Ubuntu image, write the manual instructions to install the Redis. So we ourselves created the Docker image for Redis. So you do Docker build, the Docker file name, it will create a Redis image. You do run, it will create a container. Now you can do a start, stop, restart. You again update that Docker files and you commit it and you push it to the Docker registry. You just need to have a Docker hub account, like GitHub account. Now I don't want it to do it from Docker file, I will pull it from Docker hub. So I will do Docker pull, so image is there, I will do Docker run on that image, I will get the container, and then I can play with the container, start, stop, restart and all. Okay, this is the flow of the Docker architecture. Like either you create the image from Docker file, either you pull that image from the Docker hub, you do Docker run, you will get the container, you just play with that container. So we will talk about all these commands one by one, like Docker pull image name. So it is actually pulling the image from Docker hub. Docker run image, you have already pulled the image, or this is actually short command also, Docker run image name. If you haven't pulled the image yet, it will do that task for you. Docker run you want to. So what it will do, it will pull the image first and it will run that image and will give you the container as a final result. Okay, so Docker run is a short command. Either what you will do, Docker pull, then Docker run. In the Docker run, it will skip the pulling part, but if that image is not available locally, it will pull first, then it will run. Docker start, stop, restart the container. Docker ps minus a, Docker images, Docker search, Docker RMI, image name, Docker container, stop container ID, all these commands are over there. So it's time to use the console and try to build the container. So we will do that in the next video. We have already seen the basic commands and all here.